I want to make some report about, let's say, a small successful story which done with our industrial partner company in Kram from Moscow, which are focused on production, especially devices for ammonia detection for industrial safety application, and they just tried some time ago try to enlarge the market, shift to medical application. And now I want to present a conception of device which are we development together with Incram company. Our motivation there to make easily instrumentation for respiratory breath test for diagnosis, rapid diagnosis of Helicobacter infection. This is infection, the first call before the cancer of stomach. And typically, it's very developed topic in medical applications. And now medical instrumentations have a lot of instruments for Helicobacter pylori infection detection as invasive and non-invasive. Typically, invasive detection connection with taking some probe from stomach and material for biopsy and searching the infection. Typically non-invasive diagnostic connection with specific breath tests, which are based on fast urea test, urea which marketed by specific isotopes of carbon. This isotopes, it's something 13 isotopes of carbon, typically content 1% in nature, and this is like say it's for enlarge the concentration of such isotope in urea, typically using some instrumentation, something laser dividing of isotopes and some dividing columns, and typically this is urea is artificial made urea which not present in nature. Typical test starts from drinking the solution of urea which comes in stomach, react with Helicobacter pylori bacteria and reproducing from lung carbon dioxide containing the specific isotope with which detected by infrared spectroscopy by optical instruments. From another way of chemical reaction, urea with Helicobacter pylori producing the ammonia. And our motivation in using this product, ammonia, and non-typical, typical urea, which not contain specific isotopes. We are trying to use, in our work, don't use the specific instrumentation, only instrumentation which are possible to find on wide market. Okay. we developed HP infection detector architecture, which based on IDEA, which have high sensitive sensors to ammonia and in other gases, which I show in the future, and high selectivity filter. This is IDEA is relativity another, which are located on a commercial market. Typically, in such tests, tried to use electrochemical sensors with high selectivity. But this is sensors are not stable in long time, because it's working like a battery, and by our information, such sensors lifetime for sensitivity range for typical detection of HP infection is something half a year. And here were our motivation to using solid state sensors, which are stable parameters. Here are the present the view of prototype of device, which contain electronic blocks, sensors, tank for storage exhaust gases, which produce the patient. Here there are some block scheme of our device and sensitivity to ammonia of our field effect sensors. Typically, sensors have high sensitivity to ammonia, which are located in sub ppm range. Here, present structure of field effect gas sensors, which are developed in our lab. Sensors is it's relatively simple. It's standard capacitors based on an N-type silicon substrate with thickness half a millimeter. With the electric layer, typically it's CO2, which located in a range of 100 nanometers, and some additional the electric layer, which gives best adhesion of palladium to CO2, and palladium electrode, which have diameter 2-3 millimeters. It depends of sensitivity of sensors. Here, the present the photo. Also, for increasing the speed of sensor response, we using preheating of structure up to 120 degree. Here present a scheme of fully assembled sensor in TO8 steel glass package. Typically here structure, here thermistors, which show the working temperature. Under the sensor located the heaters, which heats the system under 120 degrees. Here present typical characteristic of sensor response based on capacity voltage dependence, which are produced, which are managed by area of spacing charges, which are created by diffusion of gas in interface of palladium electrode and CO2 the electric layer. creating the some space charge, which are shift the characteristic. Shifting of characteristic are produce the our response. Structure if size 4 to 4 millimeters, just a simple silicon chip produced by pulse laser deposition on a vacuum laser machine, which are tuned to special regime, which gives a gate, palladium gate with high porous. Here the present same photo from top, and same photo which made by focused ion beam that show that characteristic of interborder layer. That layer is especially need for increase the time of response, because diffusion in a solid body, it's one of specific delay of response for type of which type this is type of sensors. Here are the present some experimental setups which are using for calibration, which contain gas mixture generator, which using special tubes contained ammonia for creation of sub ppm concentration of ammonia, and also another gases, interfering gases, which we are using in our experiment. Okay, also we're using some electronics boards for data acquisition. And here that's present a sensor which are located and stream of target gases. What we may say about experiment about stability of our structure? First, sensitivity. In right corner, present response of sensors to different type of gases. We using two type of gases. It's nitrogen contained gases and sulfur contained gases. It's possible to see that sulfur containing gases response as much higher than nitrogen contained gases. Sometimes in order, and also sensors have very nice response to hydrogen. That's very urgent for us because we want to have sensors which are sensitive to all inorganic gases which may produce the human body. Also, if we talking about stability, here the present serial measuring in in a low humid atmosphere in a laboratory room by days and days, and possible to see that fluctuation of capacity, it's near the 10 picofarads. That means signals, interfering signals located in this area that possible to tell that for nitrogen, that interfering signal, it's something low than 100 ppb. It's a typical fluctuation error. Also, sensors sensitive to humidity, but this is a sensitivity is additive, which possible if you're using humidity sensors, you may tuning the error of sensor and predict the behavior of sensors. Also, sensor working under relatively low temperature around 120, 140 degrees. That means sensor didn't produce interfering gases by chemical reactions. Because typical reactions of sensors, we know it's from a field of metal oxide sensor, starts from 200 degrees. We especially to reduce temperature for excluding the producing the interfering gases. Also, they're very interesting that such type of sensors and such temperatures is insensitive to work organic gases, which produce in big volume by bodies. And next step, the construction of a selective pneumatic scheme of device. Here present four stage of working developed device. First stage is just exhaust gas sample which took from patients goes to tank and collect in tank. All valves is closed and just collecting. Second stage is just close the input valve and start the pumping gases through the valve and coming back to tank through the sensor's chambers. It's first measurement which are working 4 or 5 minutes. After five minutes, valve three is closed and sampling gas sampling start goes through the filter, which are selectivity reduce concentration of ammonia, just absorb only ammonia, and goes to through the tank. After the next 5 minutes, concentrations of ammonia disappear from gas sampling, and you are obtain the differential signal between input samples and output samples without containing of ammonia. That means you are obtain the clean signal from ammonia concentration on the background of another gases which contain human exhaust. Okay, that device contains some software for patient data acquisition. Here we present some screenshot of this systems. And the last slide is a result of HP infection diagnostic and comparison with another test with rapid urea test and cytological screening test. And our last column, it's our self-developed devices, and possible to see that for some disease, mainly 90% of screening gives the positive signal, but some diseases gives negative signal, but we thinking that connection with specific specific of patient and specific of concentration Helicobacter pylori in stomach. Typically, our device working, like say, the same on the same the same tolerance like a rapid urea test. That's our story about developing of HP infection diagnosis device based on solid state semiconductor sensors. Also, it's possible scheme to using in another in our diseases, which are possible to detect by breath test. Also, this is scheme possible to use it for in diseases which connecting with dentistry, because sulfur contained gases, it's a signal which are patients have problem with teeth, and just changing of filter in such device possible to to apply this diagnostic gas analyzer for in our diseases. Okay, thank you. Do you have questions?
Thank you for your presentation. Questions from the audience? I have little questions. Are there similar equipment on the market?
Not.
Not.
I just especially don't show that devices because need some permission from, from these devices and some critics. Typically on market located such system which contained electrochemical sensors.
Next question: why is system better than ours?
Why? Don't need using the specific isotope content of urea, and also solid state devices, which are very very stable with long time, because it's working in diffusion mode and not chemical reaction, and typically such sensors working up to 15 years. It's impossible to compare with electrochemical sensors which working in better 2-3 years. It's sensor for ammonia. Real sensors sensitive. In a sub ppm range, real sensors, electrochemical, working in regime which need for HP infection detection, just a half of year.
And okay, thank you.
Thank you very much.
I want to add the main idea, which are asking us in hospitals, because when you put the new sensors, when replace your sensor, you need new calibration by ammonia. That's a little bit problem for hospitals. They want to exclude this operation.
Okay. Thank you for the presentation.